You know you've done this before. It's late and you're ready to go to bed, but your Fitbit says you've only hit 9,950 steps today. So you're walking up and down the hallway to make sure you hit that goal before you hit the sack. Because you've got to get those steps in, right? Well, I mean, yes, because walking is really good for your health in a lot of ways, but also, no. Even though walking is an important part of your routine, it's definitely not enough to be your whole routine. And this is what you need to be doing along with it. Hey Killer Bees, it's Paula B, your best middle-aged fitness friend. And around here, we are all about making peace with your menopausal body by finding a healthy weight and moving in ways that feel like self-love. And walking is a great part of finding a healthy weight because it totally feels like self-love. Unless that's all you're doing. My mom loves to walk, even though she's had so much trouble with it, including broken bones and the whole teeth situation that I mentioned in the title of this video. She's been an avid daily walker for well over 10 years. And before that, she had a long career in retail, so she's always been on her feet and moving around. And I know she enjoys it because it's very social. I mean, she always walks with a friend or two. And let's be honest, because it's so simple. I mean, all you have to do is put on your shoes and walk out your front door. Boom, you've exercised for the day. Also, it's very measurable, which I think is the biggest appeal for many of us. You know, you wear a device on your wrist and all day long you have this running total, pun intended, of what you've accomplished during the day. And device makers totally know that. So there's this thing in psychology called the Ovsiankina effect, which is much easier to call the completion principle, that states that leaving something unfinished is incredibly uncomfortable to the human brain, which you, if you've ever worn a tracking device, have absolutely felt. I mean, you want to close those rings. You want to see the animated fireworks, which is great because, I mean, that's helping to keep you motivated to move every day. Except that your step count isn't telling the whole story of your health or your fitness. A few years ago, my mom started falling. At first, it was a stumble here or there that maybe left a bruise on her arm or her leg. But then, one time, she missed the last step of the staircase and wound up with a broken ankle that required 2 surgeries. And another time, she lost her footing on the uneven sidewalk and fell down hard, right on her face. She wound up in the emergency room with 2 of her front teeth that eventually got pulled, damaged beyond repair. Now, my mom's only 79 years old, and she's not some frail old lady, you know? She walks every day. So how did this happen to her? Well, my friends, this is the sneaky problem with only watching your step count to measure your fitness. You're missing out on other, like, really vital exercises. So walking is one of the most efficient things we do. It's a movement pattern that we learn in our first year or two of life, and it's the primary way that we move every single day. So on the one hand, efficiency is great because we don't need a lot of energy to walk and our body is very good at it. On the other hand though, here's where the problem comes in. When you get efficient at doing something, your body doesn't recruit all the muscles that it would for a new, different movement. Really specifically, it doesn't ask your core muscles to do any work. And the weaker your core is, the worse your balance gets. Balance exercises that strengthen your core are truly essential work for all of us as we get older, for a couple of reasons. Number one, obviously, is to prevent falls altogether by staying stable on your feet. Number two, though, is that if you do stumble, you're less likely to get hurt because the muscles and the tendons that work for balance are strong enough to resist injury. Number three, my favorite, is that practicing your balance actually makes you better and stronger at every other exercise you do. For reals, you will actually get more benefit from your cardio workouts like walking when you have the strong, stable core and excellent brain-body connection that you can only get from practicing your balance. Now, here's the thing. I get it. I mean, even though you know it's good for you, balance practice is kind of boring on a good day and really humbling most of the time. It's not easy because you're not efficient at it. And it doesn't count according to your watch. Standing on one foot racks up literally 0 steps, you know, because you're not moving. It's been an uphill battle convincing my mom that she needs to practice her balance. She'll do a couple of exercises for a couple of days, and then the motivation just sort of fizzles out. So here's what I tell her and what I'm telling you. Rather than trying to do a ton of balance work all at once, just add a teeny teeny tiny bit into your day, here and there. When you're doing the dishes, stand on one foot for a few seconds. When you get up from the couch, do a couple of slow kicks. Work your balance practice into things that you're already doing and enjoying, like this low-impact cardio workout that'll get you about 1,000 steps and some super fun balance practice. Check it out now, and I'll see you over there.